As a result of the MPC-NCNC alliance with the Action Group in opposition, the federal government of the First Republic was dominated by Northerners and Easterners, while the Westerners were allegedly marginalized until Chief Samuel Aduke Akintola formed the NNDP, creating an alliance with the MPC. Aja Onwuachukwu, an Igbo of the NCNC, was the Federal Minister of Education from 1958 to 1965. He was instrumental in the appointment of Professors Njoku as Vice Chancellor of the University of Lagos in 1962 and Kenneth Onwuka Adike as the Vice Chancellor of Ibadan in 1963. Both were Igbo men. Although qualified, there were more senior Yoruba professors, among them Professor Oladele Ajose, the first tenured professor in Nigeria. This did not go down well with the leading Yoruba politicians of the day, and when Chief Richard Akinjide became Minister of Education in 1965, the University of Lagos Governing Council refused to renew Njoku's tenure as Vice-Chancellor, and Professor Saburi Biobaku, a renowned historian and an Egba man from Igbori Abeokuta, present-day Ogun State, was appointed as Vice-Chancellor. As a result, the university community was engulfed in crisis, and students of the University of Lagos at the time believed that the government's decision was laden with ethnic favoritism. They resisted the idea and protested against the action. They threatened fire and brimstone and asked the Minister of Education, Chief Richard Akinjide, to stop Biobaku from moving near the university's premises. The students were opposed to change in the leadership of the university. But the government ignored the students' threats and vowed that its decision was final and irreversible. Having foreclosed the issue, the Sir Abubakar Tafawa Balewa-led federal government notified the new vice-chancellor that he had no cause to fear and that the security agencies were there to give him adequate protection on the campus. In a blissful mood, Biobaku relied on the assurances given to him by the government to resume his new duty post, and he made his way straight to the vice-chancellor's lodge at UNILAG, where he dropped his belongings. Interestingly, he was received by the principal officers of the university and thereafter formally assumed duty at the vice-chancellor's office. On assumption of duty in June 1965, as it was customary for a new vice-chancellor, Biobaku prepared to address the students and other members of the academic community. He needed to extend his hands of fellowship to them and acquaint himself with the environment. As the professor mounted the podium of the university auditorium in the presence of a large crowd of students and members of the academic community awaiting his inaugural speech, he received more than he had bargained for. Biobaku least expected it. A radical student activist identified as Kayode Adams surged forward from the crowd and stabbed the vice-chancellor at the back, ostensibly in protest against Njoku's removal. Biobaku fell and Adams was immediately arrested by the police. There was tension in the university and the incident resulted in the closure of the school for months. After Biobaku's medical treatment, he returned to UNILAG and served his tenure without any further hitch. Since that unfortunate incident 56 years ago, the University of Lagos has never again witnessed any physical attack on any of our vice-chancellors. After his release, Kayode Adams committed suicide by drowning in the Takwa Bay Beach in Lagos in October 1969. We always have more stories to tell, so if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. You can also check out our next video to know more about Kenneth Onwuka Adike, the first Vice-Chancellor of the University of Ibadan.